أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا كثيرا مباركا فيه والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد. My dear and respected brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Indeed, successful are those who bear patiently. Indeed, Allah is with those who bear patiently. We are no doubt living in trying and difficult times, somewhat unusual times, somewhat strange times, and times filled with fear perhaps by some. Times when we feel and can see that we are maybe lacking in some resources. Times when we clearly see that some of our freedoms have been snatched away from us, taken away from us. Times when we feel very much limited, but it is still time. The true believer is always conscious of his time. The Almighty God swore by the time. The Quran says, "Wal asri innal insana lafi khusr." By the time. Indeed, human is at loss, but they are exceptions. Except those who believe and do righteous deeds and encourage each other towards the truth and towards the patience. Imam Shafi rahmatullah alayhi once said, if this passage of the Quran was the only thing to be revealed to the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, arguably it would have sufficed the mankind to guide them to Allah. The main objective and purpose of sending down the revelations of the Quran would have been achieved, and that is to guide the mankind to Allah. Indeed, if humans only realize the blessing of time, whether it is trying times, blissful times, happy times, or difficult times, there are still time, and it is always equal amount of time that we have. And indeed, as Imam Al-Ghazali rahmatullah alayhi said, we are composed of nothing but time. We are composed of days and nights, or of days. Every day we are spending our days, and we are having less and less time left before we meet our Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is why everyone, except those who believe in God and do righteousness and establish the truth and encourage each other to patience, towards patience, will be at loss. They are indeed losers. So my brothers and sisters, let us be mindful of our time. Let us remember this noble chapter of the Quran, that everyone is at loss except those who use their time for good, except those who spend their time in worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why our Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam said once, نِعْمَتَانِ مَغْبُونٌ فِيهِمَا كَثِيرٌ مِنَ النَّاسِ الصِّحَّةُ وَالْفَرَاغُ. Indeed, there are two blessings many people are neglectful about, and they are indeed the health, well-being, good health, and free time. And that's why the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam also told us, advised us very nicely and very clearly, take the advantage of free time before you become so busy. Spend your youth before you become older. Use your health before you lose it, before you become ill and well. But it is really all about time. And that is why the scholars have said, you can't really measure time with anything. It's more valuable than the gold. It is in fact the most valuable of all things that we possess, that we have. So I urge you, my respected brothers and sisters, my respected viewers, to use the moments, I don't want to say days and nights this time, and minutes of the blessed month of Ramadan, and all the time which is ahead of us in our lives, to serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our teacher, our true master, The Blessed Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam was so conscious of Allah. He used all of his time in remembering Allah, in praying to Him, seeking His forgiveness, repenting to Him sincerely, worshipping Him day and night, dedicating his entire body for the service and servitude of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we too must realize that time is precious. It is so valuable of a blessing that we should never underestimate it. And we must use it to our advantage. And indeed, the best thing that we could do in our time is that we perform our deeds and tasks solely for Allah's sake. We purify our intentions and we do whatever we do in the name of God, in the name of Allah, solely for His sake and making sure that we are in tune with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obeying His commands and abstaining from His prohibitions, staying away from bad traits and doing all that is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once again, I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He accepts our fasts from us and our prayers. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the tawfiq in all of our deeds and indeed to lead us towards the deeds and actions and sayings and prayers that He loves, that are beloved to Him. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us any mistakes and shortcomings that we might have had until now in our lives. May Allah bless you and bless your times. Barakallahu feekum, wal'afu minkum, wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.